I've been using my Sigenergy system for 3 weeks now, and it's so good. Switching on electrical appliances whenever we like and not having to pay for electricity feels so weird. Many of you asked in my previous video about how many solar panels do we actually need. So in this video, I'm going to share a couple of the actual scenarios I've experienced, such as the issue of not having enough solar panels to charge your EV, and how to calculate the right solar system size for your consumption. And as a disclaimer, I'm not an electrician. I'm just a happy solar battery consumer sharing my actual usage experience. Hi everyone, welcome to another Sky Perspective video. I have a Sigenergy 24 kilowatt battery and a single phase 10 kilowatt inverter. Yes, we can totally eliminate our electricity bill even when we drive an EV. Yes, I'm charging my EV for free now, but we will need to have a large solar system. If you drive an EV like me, I highly recommend going for a solar panel size of at least 14 kilowatt. Why 14 kilowatt when my inverter is only 10 kilowatt? I'll explain later in the video. So this is how I calculate the size of my solar system. My household consumes 15 to 25 kilowatt hour of electricity per day during summer and winter days because of heating and cooling. And during spring and autumn, we consume about 10 kilowatt hour per day. On days when I plug in and charge my BYD Seal EV, I'll be drawing an additional 20 kilowatt hour per day. So that's charging my BYD Seal EV for 3 hours at 7 kilowatt of power. Charging 1 3-hour sessions like that will only bring my BYD Seal's battery from 30% to 70% roughly. So I need 2 of those 3-hour sessions to top up my BYD Seal from 30 to 100%. Now, take note of the figure 7 kilowatt over 3 hours because this is the first reason why we need more solar panels to support this. So over last few weeks, on days where I did charge my BYD Seal EV, we consumed about 40 kilowatt hour for that single day. Basically 20 kilowatt hour for our household and 20 kilowatt hour charging my EV, well roughly, and just for that one single day. Now, this is the problem if you don't have enough solar panels. On a cloudy, rainy day, even though my system is larger than 14 kilowatt, it is only generating 7.3 kilowatt, fluctuating between 5 to 8 kilowatt to be exact. So the Sigenergy AC EV charger will need to throttle the charging power and unable to charge at its full 7 kilowatt capacity. And if the solar drops too low, you'll get message like this. This is because we select charging using solar panels only. Of course, you can switch over to buy electricity from the grid to charge the EV, but our aim is not to pay for any electricity, remember? And this is another scenario where the solar is only generating 3.6 kilowatt, and my family is at home consuming about 1.8 kilowatt. So there is only 2.45 kilowatt left to charge my EV. My Sigenergy battery will need to kick in and help give it a little bit more boost. And remember, initially I mentioned we need 7 kilowatt for 3 hours, and in this scenario, we are only charging at 2.45 kilowatt, which is less than half the speed of 7 kilowatt. And let's take a look at this optimum solar power scenario. This is the optimum power we want. Full sun and my panels are generating 14 kilowatt, and about 7 kilowatt is charging my car. My home is using 1.5 kilowatt. There is still about 5 kilowatt, which is also charging my home battery for us to use electricity at night. And remember, I need 3 hours of this constant 7 kW to charge my BYD Seal to bring it from 30% to 70%. So this is primarily the reason why I recommend you need at least 14 kW system if you want to charge your EV at 7 kW. You will need a large maximum power output of 14 kW at that given time when you charge your EV, because your EV AC charger will be consuming 7 kW already. Now, if you want to generate 14 kW at any one time to charge your EV like the above scenario, you will need more than 14 kW solar panels. The reason is because there are lots of factors that will prevent the solar panels generating at their full efficacy. For example, you might not have enough roof space. Even if you want a system size of 14 kW or more, you may not have the roof space to install 30 to 35 panels. And the other thing is the orientation of your roof. How much roof space do you have facing north? North-facing panels work the best. East and west facing panels are still good, but won't perform as well because of morning and afternoon sun. The third factor that affects is birds droppings. Imagine you have a string of 6 kW west panels where one panel has bird droppings on them. The whole entire string performance will drop because of that one single panel. Watch this video which explains more on this topic. The other thing is shading. Some of your panels might always be shaded at a certain time of the day. For example, your neighboring buildings might be taller and may shade your east panels every afternoon after 2 p.m., for example. And the other shading factor is you've got to make sure things on your roof, like your antenna or the power supply, or things like sewage vent pipe and wily birds, do not shade your panels. Now, having said that, new panels nowadays, like the Jinko panels, have half-cell technology that allows electricity current to bypass cells that are shaded. This will prevent power loss across the entire string of panels. So it's worthwhile considering this type of newer panels if shading is a potential issue. For all those above reasons, it's always good to have a solar panel system size larger than the inverter size. So my panel size is larger than 14 kW, and I only have a 10 kW inverter. So how in the world is my 10 kW inverter able to handle 14.1 kW of solar generation? Now, before I continue, if you find this video useful so far, consider buying me a super thanks to help support my work on this channel. And if you want to install a Sigenergy systems like mine and eliminate your electricity bill down to zero, give my installer a call and mention my YouTube channel Sky Perspective so they can look after you. Now back to the topic. The answer lies in AC and DC electrical current. The power produced by solar panels is DC current. In this scenario, where my solar panels is generating 14.1 kW of power, my inverter is converting 7 kW of the panel's DC power into AC for my AC EV charger to charge my EV. As well as, it is converting 1.86 kW of AC power for my home. The rest of the 5 kW from the solar panels is going directly into the Sigenergy battery, which is from the panel's DC current to the battery DC current. The inverter doesn't need to convert any of those power to AC because the solar panels is DC and the battery is also operating using DC current. It's basically direct power from the panels into the battery. So when we say 10 kW inverter, what we mean is the inverter is able to convert 10 kW of DC current into AC current for our home consumption or even to sell to the grid. Once again, I'm not an electrician, so I hope what I'm sharing above is correct. Feel free to correct me in the comments down below if I got anything wrong. So just to recap, Solar panels operate in DC. Our home electricity is consuming AC. Exporting electricity to the grid is also AC. Sigenergy 7 kilowatt AC charger is AC, and the Sigenergy 12 kilowatt DC charger is DC. So anytime when we need to convert DC to AC, we need to use our inverter to convert the AC to DC current. So now, to answer the question of how many solar panels do we need, you will need to look into your last 12 months of electricity bill and find the highest consumption day, which is generally in winter time. And then ask your solar installer to give you a graph like this one, which shows the daily expected power generation at different time of the year based on a solar system size. Keep asking them to increase the solar panel size until those daily estimated solar generated power is above your consumption. And if you have an EV, don't forget to think about those days when you charge your EV at 7 kilowatt, as I mentioned earlier, if you intend to get the Sigenergy 7 kilowatt AC EV charger. Remember to like this video if you find it useful, so YouTube will push more of my solar battery videos to you. Thanks for watching this one, and I'll see you in the next video.